come to the stage.
Bernie, come.
Assalamualaikum.
Nanti.
Mas ya. Namanya teman mas.
Assalamualaikum.
Adik, duduk. Ini siapa yang megang sendal ini? Duduk. Ya, pinta.
Khalik. Assalamualaikum.
Allahu Akbar.
Assalamualaikum.
Waalaikumsalam.
This one. Assalamualaikum.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi.
Assalamualaikum.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على حبيبك المصطفى عليه أفضل الصلاة والسلام. الحمد لله الذي جعلنا مسلمين ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدًا عبده وحبيبه ورسوله. أيها المؤمنون الحاضرون، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. It's a great honor for me to be here tonight with the invitation of the Sufi Festival, which been managed and done by our son, famous one, that he does that for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and for Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on his own expenses, our son Ahmad Dani.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Suatu kehormatan bagi saya pribadi, begitu informasi dari Maulana Syekh Hisham Kabbani, berada di sini bersama jamaah muslim yang ada di Pondok Indah ini. Saya mengucapkan banyak-banyak terima kasih dan penghargaan setinggi-tingginya bagi saudara Ahmad Dani yang sudah saya anggap bagaikan putra sendiri, yang telah menyelenggarakan acara ini malam ini kita bersama-sama dalam Sufi Islam Festival. Dia mengerjakan ini dan merealisasikan majelis ini untuk kehormatan Allah Subhanahu wa taala dan Rasulnya Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
I'm not going to be long because I have a surprise for you. You like surprises?
Saya mungkin tidak terlalu panjang, tetapi mungkin ada satu kejutan dari saya. Apakah kalian suka dengan kejutan?
I'm not going to tell you what is the surprise now, but later.
Mungkin nanti saya akan beritahu apa kejutan itu.
We are here for one thing, that word which is very important. All of you, you have that, but all of us, we forget about it. It is one word, it's so easy on the tongue, very simple to say. Everyone is able to say it, but it needs a clean heart and a beautiful heart.
Ada satu kata yang sangat mendalam sekali maknanya bagi kita semua. Satu kata yang sebetulnya kita semua tahu, tetapi dalam waktu yang bersamaan kita semua juga lalai dan alpa atas kalimat yang baik tersebut. Kalimat itu mudah diucapkan.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created creation for human beings. When Allah wanted to send Adam on earth, He created and prepared for him earth. He didn't prepare for him Mars or Venus or Jupiter. There is no life there. He gave him a beautiful nature. It's a reflection of heavens on earth. He gave him the reflection of heaven. He made this earth full of beautiful things around us, from trees, from skies, from stars, from moon, from sun, everything in a different way, from animals, all kinds of animals, underwater, above water, in the sky, all kinds of different colors, all that for whom? For human beings.
Sudah demikian Allah Subhanahu wa taala memuliakan kita sebagai umat manusia yang hidup di dunia ini. Allah menciptakan dunia dengan segala isinya untuk menghormati kita. Kita tidak ditempatkan di planet Jupiter, Venus ataupun Mars. Di planet-planet itu kehidupan kita mungkin tidak pernah ada. Planet-planet itu tidak cocok untuk kita. Tetapi Allah memuliakan kita di bumi ini, di dunia ini. Dengan segala yang ada di sini, kita bisa menikmati air, sungai, pohon-pohonan, angin, bintang, langit, dan semua yang ada. Semuanya untuk kehormatan manusia. Begitulah Allah Subhanahu wa taala menspesialkan kita.
Look at birds. All of them different colors. Beautiful colors. Look at fish in the ocean. They're all of them different colors. Look at trees. All of them different flowers, different colors. Look at you, all of you, different faces, different color, different dress, different heart, different souls, different in everything. Allah said, "Inna khalaqnakum min dhakarin wa unsa wa ja'alnakum shu'uban wa qaba'ila lita'arafu. Inna akramakum 'inda Allahi atqakum." Oh people, we have created you from male and female, as we have made you nations and tribes to know each other. The best among you is the most sincere, is the most generous. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave this us free, gave this world for us free to say live in happiness, live in harmony, because the secret word that Allah loves from people, I am going to say it later.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala menciptakan kita sebagai keturunan Adam alaihi salam yang diturunkan di bumi ini sebagai khalifahnya. Allah menciptakan segala sesuatu untuk kita. Kita tinggal mengambil secara gratis, secara cuma-cuma. Kita dengan sangat mudahnya memanfaatkan apa yang ada diciptakan oleh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sebagai al-khaliq. Dalam sebuah firman Al-Quran, Allah menyatakan kepada kita dan menginformasikan kepada kita, telah menciptakan engkau wanita dan pria sehingga berbangsa-bangsa, hingga kemudian hari berkumpul kita bersama-sama, tetapi kita tidak ada yang satu berbeda satu sama lain. Ruh kita berbeda, sifat kita berbeda, pikiran kita berbeda. Begitulah Allah memuliakan kita.
Oh Muslims, oh mu'min, oh human beings in general, be happy. Paradise is for you. If Allah gave us paradise on earth, He is not going to give us a paradise in heaven.
Oleh karena itu, kita sebagai umat manusia, sebagai muslim, bergembiralah atas segala karunia Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Kelak Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala akan memberikan surga bagi kita di akhirat. Allah tidak memberikan surga sekarang di bumi. Nanti Allah akan berikan kita di kehidupan yang abadi kelak. Amin.
Look at your beautiful Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. look at what he said and think about it and say, oh, I must be like that. I must do like that. Because if I do that, I will be saved.
Bercerminlah kita, menataplah kita kepada contoh kita, junjungan kita Nabi besar Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Kita mengikuti beliau, maka kita akan selamat dimanapun kita berada.
One time Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was doing Jum'ah, and he was doing khutbah al-Jum'ah, and in the middle, when Prophet was on the minbar, someone came, a Bedouin came, a Bedouin from the desert, a Bedouin that doesn't know anything. But he wants to learn. He wants something easy, not something difficult. He stood at the door and said, Ya Muhammad, Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad. Look, he didn't say even Ya Rasulallah. He didn't say Ya Sayyidi Ya Rasulallah. He said, Ya Muhammad. As if he's talking to someone that's very close to him. When someone is very close to you, you don't call him Mr. You don't call Mrs. You call directly the name. You say Abdurrahman. Or you say Fatima. You don't say Sayyida Fatima. You don't say Sayyid Abdurrahman. Directly the name. So he said, Ya Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Tell me, when is the day of judgment? When Allah wants to judge people of what they have done.
Ada suatu kisah bagi kita semua yang sangat bagus dijadikan contoh. Suatu kisah yang dialami oleh Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Ketika itu beliau sedang memberikan khutbah Jum'ah. Ketika beliau sedang memberikan khutbah, tiba-tiba ada seorang badui yang sangat miskin, yang tidak tahu apa-apa tetapi ingin belajar dari Rasulullah SAW. Di tengah-tengah khutbah, sang badui itu memanggil Rasulullah, Ya Muhammad. Badui tidak memanggil Ya Rasulullah kepada Muhammad SAW. Dia hanya memanggil nama. Begitulah pendidikan orang badui pada saat itu. Dia tidak menghormati dan tidak memberikan kehormatan sebagaimana pantasnya kepada Rasulullah SAW. Ketika itu beliau sedang memberikan khutbah.
And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam didn't answer. Then he said another time, Ya Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when is the day of judgment? And Prophet did not answer. He did not cut his Jum'ah. Third time, he's asking, Ya Muhammad, when is the day of judgment? And Jibril alayhi salam came and said, Ya Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah send you salam, saying to you, answer him. Look, Allah, how much he loves his servant. Make his prophet to answer the Bedouin. Makes the perfect man to listen to a simple person. Today, in every country, leaders doesn't speak to people even. They speak behind veils. They speak behind doors. They don't bother to speak with simple people. People must speak with their leaders. Look, Sayyidina Umar, Sayyidina Abu Bakr, Sayyidina Uthman, Sayyidina Ali. Their doors were open. Anyone comes and go inside, sit beside them. They don't say, oh, we are leaders, don't sit with us. Their doors are open. O Muslims, make your door open to everyone. Allah made his Prophet Sayyidina Muhammad door open to that Bedouin, telling him in Jum'ah on the minbar, answer the Bedouin.
Apa yang ditanyakan oleh orang Badui itu kepada Rasulullah SAW ketika beliau memberikan khutbah? Seorang Badui itu bertanya beberapa kali dan tidak dijawab oleh Rasulullah. Kapan datangnya hari kiamat? Kapan datangnya hari penghitungan itu, Ya Muhammad? Sampai suatu ketika beberapa kali tidak dijawab, turunlah Sayyidina Jibril AS menyampaikan pesan dari Allah Subhanahu wa taala. Ya Sayyidina Muhammad, ada salam dari Allah Subhanahu wa taala dan perintah untuk menjawab orang Baduy itu. Lalu Rasulullah berkenan untuk menjawab. Lihat, ini adalah satu contoh bagi kita. Orang, makhluk yang paling mulia, makhluk yang paling sempurna di alam semesta ini, Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, diberikan Allah kemuliaan dan diberikan perintah untuk menjawab orang Baduy itu yang beberapa kali bertanya tentang yaumil qiyamah. Coba kita lihat contoh di zaman sekarang ini, di bumi ini, beberapa pemimpin dunia bahkan tidak pernah mau, tidak pernah mau menyempatkan waktu untuk berbicara dengan masyarakatnya. Kalaupun mereka berbicara, paling hanya di dalam TV ataupun tertutup oleh ruangan-ruangan tertentu. Bagaimana dengan Sayyidina Umar, Sayyidina Abu Bakar, Sayyidina Utsman, dan Sayyidina Ali? Ketika beliau-beliau para sahabat menjadi pemimpin dan khalifah, beliau tidak pernah berpisah dari masyarakatnya. Beliau-beliau tidak pernah berpisah dari umat-umatnya dan tidak pernah merasa eksklusif dan memisahkan diri.
And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was so happy that Allah gave him permission, and he was so happy because he understand humbleness, how much it's important to listen to a Bedouin. To answer a Bedouin means is answer the most simple person.
Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam begitu gembira dan bahagianya mendapatkan salam dari Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam melalui Sayyidina Jibril. Menerima pengajaran langsung mengenai bagaimana rendah hati, bagaimana menjadi tawadu, menjawab pertanyaan dari seorang Badui yang sangat sederhana.
He said, "Oh Bedouin, it's a long travel. What you prepare for that travel? What you prepared when you arrive to the immigration of the Day of Judgment? There are immigrations there, like today they have immigration at the customs. There are angels immigrations there, officers. They are going to ask where you are coming. Do you have a visa to enter to paradise or you have a visa to enter to hell? Allahu Akbar. Do you have a visa? Okay, go inside to paradise. Don't have visa, we don't give at the border visa, go to hell. What you are preparing for that day is a long way to go. What you have done? Did you pray? Did you fast? Did you give zakat? Did you give charity? Did you go to hajj? What you did? Tell me."
Atas pertanyaan dari seorang Baduy itu, Rasulullah menjawab dengan pertanyaan kembali mengenai kapan datangnya yaumil hisab, datangnya hari penghitungan itu. Rasulullah bertanya kepada Baduy itu, "Itu suatu perjalanan yang sangat panjang sekali. Apa yang sebenarnya telah engkau siapkan untuk hari tersebut, wahai Baduy?" Kita kalau pergi ke luar negeri atau kemanapun, kadang-kadang kita ada petugas imigrasi yang memeriksa paspor kita atau tiket kita. Demikian juga dengan ini, Rasulullah bertanya kepada Baduy itu, "Sebenarnya apa yang sudah disiapkan engkau untuk hari tersebut?"
He looked what he wants to answer. All Sahaba want to listen to see what the Bedouin is going to say. Because everyone was worried. Even Sahaba, they were worried that it is a long travel. How they can pass through the door of the immigration of the Day of Judgment. They are afraid also. Everyone will be afraid in Day of Judgment from the divine presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Allah want to ask us, if a policeman stop you at the road, you will be afraid. What you think about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Day of Judgment? All prophets will be shaking, will be trembling. So Sahaba wants to know, what's that Bedouin going to say?
Rasulullah menjawab dengan pertanyaan sebagaimana yang tadi telah kita ketahui. Apa yang telah engkau siapkan, wahai Baduy, atas dengan perjalanan ini yang panjang menuju yaumil hisab? Para sahabat sangat kaget dan sangat berharap, bercampur dengan takut, apa yang akan dijawab oleh Baduy ini mengenai apa yang telah dia siapkan untuk suatu perjalanan panjang itu.
I'm not going to be long. because the surprise is that our son Ahmad Dani is going to sing till morning.
Saya tidak akan terlalu panjang-panjang. Barangkali nanti putra kami Ahmad Dani akan bernyanyi terus sampai pagi hari.
So, what he said when Prophet asked him, "What you are going to, what you have for the day of judgment?" And he said one word. You like to say it?
Yes.
Baduy itu menjawab, "Saya punya satu kata." Menjawab pertanyaanmu ya Muhammad, katanya, "Ya Rasulullah, kalian ingin mengucapkan kalimat itu?" Tanya Maulana.
Yeah.
Higher. You like to say it?
Yeah.
Better, more. You like to say it?
Yeah.
Look there, it is written there. Tell them.
Itu ada tulisannya di sana tuh, yang merah itu apa tuh kalimat?
Cinta.
Cinta.
He said, "I love you, ya Muhammad." This is what he said. Bedouin said, "Mahabbatak ya Rasulullah, your love, ya Muhammad."
Baduy itu menjawab dengan sangat tegas dan lantang, "Aku mencintai engkau, ya Muhammad. Mahabbatak ya Muhammad."
You love Muhammad?
Yes.
Say in.
Apakah kita semua mencintai Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam?
Don't say yes, say cinta Muhammad.
Katakan cinta Rasulullah.
Cinta Rasulullah.
Cinta Rasulullah.
Cinta Allah.
Cinta Allah.
Cinta Allah.
Allahu Akbar.
Allahu Akbar.
Allahu Akbar.
Allahu Akbar.
Allahu Akbar.
اللهم صل على محمد
اللهم صل على محمد.
So what you think Prophet answered him?
Coba kita pikir apa yang kemudian akan dijawab oleh Rasulullah SAW atas jawaban Baduy tersebut.
What he answered him 1400 years ago is answering us now when we say cinta ya Rasulullah.
Jawaban yang dikemukakan oleh Baduy tersebut 14 abad yang lalu lebih diperlukan bagi kita semua di saat sekarang ini, di zaman ini.
What he said it is enough, ya Baduy, it is enough to love me is enough, I guarantee you paradise.
Lalu Rasulullah menjawab kepada Baduy itu, "Sudah cukup cintamu kepadaku ya Baduy untuk membawa engkau ke surga."
Do you want paradise?
Yes.
Apakah kita semua ingin masuk surganya Allah?
Yes.
Then we say we love Muhammad.
We love Muhammad.
Cinta ya Rasulullah.
Cinta ya Rasulullah.
So we coming here because we love each other. This is a sign of happiness. Allah created creation to love each other. Why there is nothing between me and Ahmad Dani business. He loves me, and they put the Sufi festival. He put all this, and those people with him work very hard. For what? Because they love you. Because they love Sufism. They love spirituality. They love Allah. They love Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They love Awliya Allah. They love all of you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them paradise.
Amin.
May Allah give us paradise.
Amin.
Kita harus menyadari untuk apa kita malam-malam begini di tempat yang terbuka ini berada di sini. Jawabannya adalah cinta. Kita mencintai sesama, lalu kita berada di sini. Saudara Ahmad Dani mengadakan acara ini pasti karena cinta kepada Allah, kepada Rasulullah, kepada para aulia Allah dan kepada kita semua. Saya dengan Ahmad Dani tidak ada hubungan bisnis apa-apa. Semata-mata karena cinta kehadirat Allah, kehadirat Rasulullah SAW.
I'm asking Ali, little bit, 2 minutes, to sing We Love You.
Saya akan meminta saudara Ali untuk menyanyi tentang cinta.
Ya Muhammad. No, we love you, we love you, we love you. So, ya Muhammad.
Mari kita sama-sama.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad. Sallu ala Muhammad.
Allahumma salli alaih.
I need your help.
Alhamdulillah.
Saya membutuhkan pertolongan kita semua, kata Syekh Ali.
I need you to express your love for Sayyidina Muhammad.
Mari kita sama-sama mengekspresikan cinta kehadirat Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
So I'm gonna sing. We love you, we love you, we love you so much. We love you, what else can you say? We're gonna say, Ya Muhammad.
يا محمد بعدين يا مولانا الشيخ بعدين
we start with سيدنا محمد and then inshallah we express our love for أولياء الله مولانا الشيخ ناظم مولانا الشيخ هشام can you explain
mari kita sama-sama mengekspresikan cinta kita khususnya kepada baginda Nabi besar Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam dan kemudian pada para aulia Allah guru-guru kita khususnya Maulana Syekh Muhammad Nazim adalah hakani dan Maulana Syekh Hisham
we love you we love you we love you so much we love you what else can we say ya Muhammad we love you we love you we love you so much we love you what else can we say ya Muhammad cinta 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 so much cinta what else can we say we love you so much we love you what else can we say thank you for everything you did from all of us we don't know our weakness we confess now we're gonna address Maulana Sheikh Nazim Sultan al-Awliya our beloved Maulana Sheikh Nazim so everybody is gonna shout Sheikh Nazim we love you we love you so much we love you what else can we say we love you so much we love you we love you so much we love you what else can we say we love you so much we love you what else can we say thank you for everything you did from all of us how can we thank you we don't know our weakness we confess Sheikh Hisham Allahumma salli ala Muhammad we love you we have to address our host gracious host Ahmed Dani for hosting this beautiful event and bringing us all together. So we're gonna sing, we love you, we love you, we love you so much. We love you, what else can we say? We love you, we love you, we love you so much. We love you, what else can we say? Thank you.
Excuse me.
Tepatlah duduk. Tepatlah duduk. Kenapa?